Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome to everyone here this morning. We have special worship today because the cantata is going to be sung. So I'm excited about that. In your bulletin are prayer concerns, people to pray for this week. All right, we have some birthdays. Monday is Kara Burmeister's birthday. Wednesday the 22nd is Seth Lake's birthday. And that's it. No one born on Christmas Day. No one born on Christmas Day. All right. Except Jesus, right? All right. But when we celebrate it, yes. All right. Okay. I'm looking at the schedule for this week, and looks like there's a Christian Ed meeting at 6 o'clock on Wednesday. Candlelight service. Please come Christmas Eve at 5 o'clock for a worship service, and then come back again on Sunday for a worship service at 9. All right. Does anyone have any announcements that they'd like to mention? Okay. Then we are going to begin the service with the lighting of the Advent candle. While Jeff's coming up, I'll say our centering words. Very air we breathe is filled with joyous expectation. The one who has done great things for us is with us now. Glory to God in the highest. Amen.
Sometimes when we are trying something new, or when we are facing a difficult decision, or when we want to celebrate something, or when we just feel lost and alone and uncertain about life, the universe and everything, we need a blessing. We don't always think of it that way, or word it like that. We say we need advice, or support, or companions, or someone to come along beside and lift us up again so we can see more than the tops of our shoes. We seek a blessing.
For many of us, we go home. We ask mom, we talk to dad, or brothers and sisters, close friends, those we grew up with, those who know us best. We want them alongside. We want to be in their presence. Somehow we know that being there, being home, will make all things better. Maybe it won't be fixed or solved or wished away, but at least we won't be alone. We seek a blessing.
Mary, faced with an incomprehensible burden and gift, ran to Cousin Elizabeth's house, looking for someone who knew little of what she was going through, looking for a place to hide until the reality of her condition could become something real. And she received a blessing. The prophet Micah spoke of a blessing coming to an unexpected place, an unassuming town. Yet, by God's grace, would become the means through which God would bless the whole world, Bethlehem, the little town of blessing. We seek a blessing.
We light these candles, the candle of hope, of peace, of joy, and of today, love. As a sign that we know blessing, and we know waiting for blessing to be felt and lived. We light these candles as a sign that we still seek a blessing. It's time to go home. Please join me in the call to worship. Come joy, lighten our spirits. Come hope, lift with us from despair. Come peace, ease our frantic worry.
Come love, shine in all we do.
Come Come, Jesus, be born in us.
Come, Lord, set us free.
Come, God.
Rule in our hearts
and teach us to sing with joy. Please stand if you're able. And our opening hymn is Hark the Herald Angels Sing, hymn number 240. Receive us into the arms of your mercy, that we may feel you near us and rest secure in your many blessings. Amen. You may be seated and ask the kids to come forward. You can buy know what? See, they're appearing right there. All right, perfect. Thank you. Thank you. God likes us to give, doesn't he? Yes. Okay, Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus is the light. Have you ever been somewhere dark where you couldn't see?
I did.
And where was that? Can you think of a time when you were in a dark place?
When the derecho hit,
when the derecho hit, you're right, we didn't have electricity, right? Have you ever been, in a hallway that was dark and you couldn't see, right? Or, and it can be a little scary, can't it?
I can't get
it. What?
I can't get
All right. Poor Michael's going, don't give him the microphone. All right. So when we're in a dark place, it can be kind of scary, right? So this is one thing. What is that?
Don't get off my eyes.
What is that?
A fat light.
A fat flashlight, that's right. And flashlights can help us see when it's dark and the electricity goes out, right? Well, we can kind of compare, think of Jesus as this flashlight. So if we didn't have a flashlight,
it'd be
dark and you might be scared, right? Might be scared, but God, Jesus, is always with you. And he can lighten up and help us to see, right? He will always be with us, keep us from danger, be with us when things might happen that are scary or dangerous. And he will show us the way, right? So we can pray about it, right? But always know that Jesus is there with you, kind of all surrounding us. I think of it as like the air we breathe, you know, Jesus being with us. And so if you're ever scared, you just say, Jesus, help me. And he's there and he will light your path. Okay?
He doesn't have the flashlight.
He doesn't have the flashlight. He has his own way of lighting the path, right? Yep. So just remember that Jesus is always with us and he can help us make decisions, help us to know how to act in a certain way, so if we're ever scared or need help, just remember and be comforted that Jesus is always with us, like the flashlight, right? Okay, so you say a prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we're so thankful that you are always with us to light our path, to be with us, to keep us from being scared, and help us the way to go. Thank you for each other, everyone that's here in worship today. Amen. Amen. We still aren't passing the plate, so if you have a tithe or an offering, there are boxes on each side in the back. We acknowledge that God gives us everything that we have, right? And we're thankful for that. So he just asked us to share and to trust him. And with that, we'll sing the doxology. Please stand. Praises for the choir, for the season. Yes, Carol.
I think all of you know that my granddaughter, Elizabeth, got a very generous scholarship from the Methodist Church for her college, which is Morningside. And last night, Morningside and Grandview of Des Moines, two Iowa schools, played for the national championship in Durham, North Carolina.
For basketball? For what sport?
For football.
For football.
And it was an amazing game. And the leads changed back and forth all the way through the game. And Iowa was very well represented. And Morningside came out on top, and they did win. And we even got to see a few fleeting glimpses of Elizabeth doing her cheering job, which she had another scholarship for.
Awesome. So, Elizabeth Stayskull, sorry about that. Elizabeth Stayskull is a freshman in college at Morningside. Did you go to the game? Did you watch it on?
Elizabeth sent the connections to get
good. So you watched it live on the computer or whatever. So she's at Morningside, and Morningside, that's a Christian college, a Methodist college,
right?
Played, tell me the other, name the other, Des Moines.
Grandview.
Okay, so for the
national championship
in football.
In this conference, you know, in their school size conference.
Yep, yep. And it was an exciting game, and Morningside came out on top. And Elizabeth, she received a scholarship from the Methodist, the United Methodist annual conference, I guess, generous scholarship, and also got a scholarship for cheerleading. So they were able to see her cheerlead at the football game, get a few glimpses of her, so that's awesome. That is awesome. All right. Anyone else? Or prayer concerns? There's some listed in our bulletin. I haven't been updated on Jeff Grimley's health condition, but please pray that they find a kidney for him. Okay, well, let's just take a moment for silent prayer, and then we'll have the pastoral prayer.
Let us pray. Almighty God, as we come before you today, we come, as always, with praise and thanksgiving, joys and concerns. We praise your name and thank you for all our many blessings. We give to you all those persons currently suffering from the COVID virus, especially with the new Omicron variant. Shield our community, especially our children, from this virus. We are mindful that there are others who are sick. We pray for them. Please grant them strength and peace and comfort that comes from you. We pray that they might all be healed swiftly and completely. We mark births, weddings, and their other milestones in our lives. We pray and lift up all who are celebrating for the blessings that you continue to give. We pray for the church, this congregation, the larger United Methodist Church, and for believers around the world. Grant us the knowledge, wisdom, and courage to faithfully witness to you in all the affairs and struggles in our church. I pray for every who has come to worship you. Lord, reach out to them and let them see your faithfulness in their love. Each of us has our own joys and concerns. While we live to you now, thank you for being our provider, Jehovah Jireh, our healer and protector. As we celebrate the Christmas season, help us always to remember that in all the busyness and preparations, the reason of the season is you. You're coming to save the world from its sin. Thank you for saving us. And indeed, we have this reason to rejoice, even in the midst of the uncertainty and problems of life that come to us every day. Thank you for coming to save us from our sins. Thank you for your love, grace, and peace. We pray all these things in the mighty name of Jesus, who has taught us how to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Now, if you'd please stand if you're able for the scripture reading. Luke 1, 39 through 45. This is a story of Mary visiting Elizabeth. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greetings, the baby leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed is she who has believed what the Lord has said to her will be accomplished." Here ends the reading, and you may be seated.
An inspiration to worship God. Today, I would like us to take a brief pause and think of a song to sing in our hearts, in praise and thanksgiving to the one who was born this season, our Savior. Let us pause and think of a song or a hymn to sing and make it alive in our life this December, the Christmas month. You can start by choosing from the songs the choir will sing, or you can choose "Joy to the World." If you choose this, be always ready to prepare a room for Jesus. O come all ye faithful. If you choose this, come to God and continue to be faithful to Him. Little drummer boy, if you choose this, be the gift for Jesus this season. Let your life be your gift to Jesus. O Holy Night, if you choose this, fall on your knees and hail Jesus as your Savior. King David wrote in Psalm 98, verses 4 through 6, "Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth, burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing. With trumpets and the blast of the drums, horn, shout for joy before the Lord, the King. Whatever song you pick, make it your life song this season and sing it always in your heart as you celebrate Christ's birth. My Christmas song is, angels we have heard at night, swiftly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo, gloria in excelsis Deo. In all my limitations, weakness and strength as your pastor, may there be a lot of glory to God. What's your song for Jesus this Christmas? What's your song for Jesus this Christmas? I hope and pray you will pick one seriously and live it more seriously. A blessed Christmas, everyone.
Now we'll have a response to the word. The God of Israel is our source of hope. Glory to God in the highest. The God of our Father is our source of strength. Glory to God in the highest. The God of our mothers is our source of courage. The God of Jesus Christ is our source of life, love and light. Glory to God in the highest. Amen. Now we will have our special music. Come, let us worship the King of the Choir.
Thank you.
rejoice and a time to give. But more than anything, Christmas is a reason to worship. So in the middle of all our holiday preparations that take time to prepare our heart, to bow down in honor of Jesus the King.
Through prophets and sages. Thank you.
The story of Jesus has been told in so many ways since his birth, but we never seem to tire of its familiar scenes. We love hearing about the men and women who touched his life, in whose lives he changed when he came. Even today, its familiar word moves a place in our hearts like nothing else can.
Thank you.
God before others.
We will shine God's light each and every day.
Go forth and bless the world.